Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, Mr. Minister. Thank you very much for being with us today. It's a great opportunity for us to have you here and to speak about Ukraine. Perhaps the first question I would like to ask you is, why do you think it's now the right time to invest in Ukraine, especially in the sector of infrastructures?
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, thank you very much for this opportunity to present our country, to present our projects. From my perspective, during last 2 years, we already proved our team of our president. We already proved that we are doing real projects, real things. We are working very fast, and if we compare previous years and last 2 years, we did a lot in terms of improvement of infrastructure in many, many sectors, starting from road construction. This year we are finishing almost 10,000 kilometers renovation, construction, new construction of state roads. We are doing a lot of projects with French companies. We are signing and we have ongoing projects with Airbus, which already fixed in our G2G agreements. We are considering new projects. We have started new projects with Alstom. So I think, and we are doing this, it's not taking years and years. It takes months, several months. So from the moment we agreed something until the moment we are doing. So because there is president, there is parliament, there is one team on all levels in government. So, I mean, that's why, probably, I would say.
Great, thank you very much. So congratulations actually on the achievement you just mentioned. Ukraine is probably the last of the emerging markets on all scales in Europe. What are your expectations for the economic growth for the next 5 years?
I think last year when everybody received COVID effect, it was nobody expects this, but even during this year, we felt, but not so hard as countries around us. So we we see that we have now very fast recovery rates, and I think we will grow closer to 5% annually starting from the next year. So it's our internal expectations. It's I think similar forecasts have IMF a little bit lower, but they are usually more conservative as we. Yeah.
So. Okay. Great. Thank you. What would be the project you're most proud of?
Already, this project was already mentioned. This is a great construction project from initial from the very beginning, and it was started 2 years ago. Until now, we see that it was a very ambitious project. On the first stages, it was focused on only road construction, but now we are starting other areas of infrastructure. We are starting railway. We are starting airports program. So. It was very ambitious project. In terms of figures, I could provide several figures. Second year in a row, we are constructing more than 4,000 only state roads, 4,000 kilometers. New program include 10 new regional airports, electrification of hundreds and hundreds kilometers of railways, buy a new fleet for UZ, for Ukrainian railways, hundreds of wagons, hundreds of trains. So it's very, very ambitious projects and thousands of bridges. So, yeah.
A lot to be done then. And we all know Ukraine. Ukraine is a great country. It's a large country in Europe. Could you maybe mention three facts about Ukraine that everyone here should remember?
First of all, Ukraine, one of the largest country in Europe, in terms of population, in terms of other parameters. Ukraine, I would say this is like you mentioned, the last emergency country in Europe, it's last opportunity to invest in this country and receive one of the highest payback rate in this region. We see this, and everybody understands this. And the thought that just you need to understand that Ukraine now is different due to president, due to his team in the parliament, government, so all level of the in all levels, it's one team, and that's why we are faster, we are reliable, and we are proving this each day.
Great, thank you very much. We are going to have a session which will be dedicated to Ukraine and the pipeline and infrastructures that you currently have and contemplating. Thank you very much for being with us here. Thank you again.